الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ابن مسعود يقول: كثرة خطايا بني آدم في الخوض في الباطل، كثرة خطايا بني آدم من الخوض في الباطل. The majority of the sins of the son of Adam, that's you of course, is because you involve yourself too much in vain talk, in useless talk, in meaningless talk, in conversations that has no purpose and no goal. Most of the sins, Ibn Mas'ud says that. كذلك في الأثر, it was reported also, كثرة النظر في الباطل يذهب بالحق من القلب. Too much looking into falsehood removes faith or the truth from your heart. لذلك من أعظم ما يميل بالإنسان عن الحق هو مخالطة الباطل. The most or the major thing that takes you away from the truth and makes you deviate is too much involvement in the batil, in the falsehood, hissan aw ma'na, whether it is physical or meaning, just talk or look or listening. That is exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. هكذا الله سبحانه وتعالى قال: وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله يكفر بها ويستهزأ بها فلا تقعدوا معهم. القلب يا إخوان مخلوق بطريقة أنه يتشرب ما يسمع شيئا فشيئا حتى يأخذه. Your heart is like a sponge. It takes things little by little until it accepts it. يعني you sit with evil people. In the beginning you hate it. And you think that they are deviated. And how can they do this? You sit the second time, it gets less and less and less and less. Then you start seeing it, what's wrong with it. You might even start defending it. And that's why you see people nowadays, they see the major sins, but it doesn't really do anything to them. They don't enjoin good and forbid evil. They don't even say anything bad about it. They don't even hate it in their heart. They just, oh well, it's none of my business, and they walk away. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it was revealed to you, O Muhammad, and to us, the believers. When you hear people talking about falsehood, evil, whether they're speaking or they are involving in it, don't sit with them until they change. And look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after that. إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلُهُمْ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلُهُمْ. If you do sit with evil people, even if you are very righteous, eventually you're going to be like them. He didn't say you will be like, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you will be like them. Well, you can come and say, but I'm not like them. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means you will be. Now you're not, but you will be, because your heart is going to accept it little by little, and that's how it is now. So, who is your friend? and what kind of gatherings you attend, and who comes to your home, and what is the conversation about. And watch those people who are so good, quote unquote. When people who are not that good come and visit them, what do? They miss the prayer, which they come to it all the time. Why? Because I have a guest at home. بِئْسَ الصَّدِيقِ وَبِئْسَ الضَّيْفِ وَبِئْسَ الصَّاحِبِ إِذَا كَانْ بِدُّ يَصْرِفَكْ عَنْ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ أَوْ عَنْ عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ أَوْ عَنْ الصَّلَاةِ فِي جَمَاعَةِ ما بدك إياه هذا الصاحب. What a horrible friend or guest who comes to your home that makes you sit at home because of him and skip the prayer. And I know most of the people sitting out there at their home right now understand what I'm talking about. Many of them I know personally, they pray and they go to the masjid, but when someone visits them, they sit at home, and their excuse, I have indidif, I have a guest. What a cheap excuse, and what a cheap faith and cheap mentality. لذلك الإنسان حتى في الدعوة إذا بدك تعمل دعوة وتجلس مع ناس فساق تدعوهم لله سبحانه وتعالى لابد إلا وأن يكون عندك علم وفهم محكم. يعني if you want to invite people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which entails that you're going to be with them or visit them or sit with them, you should not do that unless you are well firm in understanding your faith, because otherwise you're going to deviate and you become one of them. You're going to make da'wah, you become one of them, and this is what the priests used to do. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why mentioned in the Quran, because they used to tell people the first time, the second time, the third time, nobody listens, then they start getting used to them little by little, they stopped making da'wah, then after that they start sitting with them. So be careful of your friends, and if you have friends who come to your home, you set the rules, not them. You tell them, hey, by the way, I go to Isha prayer, inshallah, why don't you come at time such and such, we eat for instance, and we go pray Isha, and we come back and we have some sweet and some coffee, and Alhamdulillah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. So let them know that you go to prayer. And that is a better way than falling into their trap. You put them in Jannah. I know you're expecting to say you make them fall in your trap. We don't have a trap. Our trap takes them to Jannah. Tayyib, Jazakum Allahu Khayran. We repeat what I just said. أعظم أو أكثر خطايا بني آدم من الخوض في الباطل وكثرة النظر في الباطل تذهب بالحق من القلب. Too much looking into falsehood removes the truth from your heart or faith, and most of the sins of the son of Adam because of getting involved too much in vain talk. Most of the gatherings is backbiting and slandering and things that doesn't benefit, and that's where you get the sins. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. And I'd like to welcome Brother Najib. Alhamdulillah, he's been trying hard to come. Time is tough, and I know he goes to other masajid, but jazakallahu khayran for coming. And jazakumullahu khayran all for coming. And I hope that the people around Unity Center eventually take heed and accept the invitation, and we like to see you here. Wallah, we like to see you here. If you need coffee, you need donuts, you need anything, inshallah, it's on me. Assalamu alaikum.